Right. Okay, I was just watching a video on astral projection and it got me thinking of some common challenges that I've heard and also some of those challenges I've experienced when attempting to astral project. And so I thought I would make this video to talk about the things that I've done to solve those challenges. I wrote some things down so that I could go through them. Let's see. The first thing is leaving the body and having a ch like challenge leaving the body. So a person is aware and they're going through the process and they're trying to exit. And I know there are different techniques for exiting the body. One can visualize climbing a rope. One can visualize like sitting up or rolling. There are different techniques that people utilize to exit the body, and they're able to use them and they work. But sometimes attempting those techniques, a person isn't able to fully exit. So I've encountered this. I've encountered this where I find myself like in sleep paralysis. I find myself in a state where I'm close to exiting the body. I'm aware and I'm trying to get out, but I can't completely get out. Sometimes I'll partially be out, where I can lift my head, where I can move my limbs, but a part of me won't completely release out of the body. So someone shared with me in a comment section of one of my videos, and they said, well, when you encounter that, send loving energy to the solar plexus region. So the solar plexus region, if one looks up chakras and where chakras are located, there's a chakra in the solar plexus region. So I ended up encountering it again, and I decided to do that. And so I was, trying to get out, and I couldn't fully exit the body. And so I just sent energy, loving energy, to solar plexus region, and I just automatically lifted up and out. So I lifted up and out, and I ended up like kind of like on my feet, the foot of the bed, and it had like this like bouncy feeling, and I was out of the body. So I didn't have to like push myself forward. It was just the sending that energy to the solar plexus region that I just automatically lifted up and out. So I would say, to try that, if you're in a state where you're trying to leave but you don't completely exit. Another thing would be like chakra balancing, just kind of an overall balancing of energy in the chakras. And that can be done a couple different ways. You can do it with hands physically, or you can do it through visualization of the hands moving through the chakras. And it would be drawing energy, one's energy, along with cosmic energy, through into the left hand, which is the female side. It's the receiving side, up through the top of the head, and then it works its way through and around and exits the male side of the body, the right side, which is the giving side. And just going through and sensing energy in those regions. And they will sometimes feel different. Some chakras will feel warmer. And this is just like hovering over the area. It's just hovering. And so sometimes some chakras will feel warmer. It'll feel fuller. And some will feel like, not as full. And so the idea is to add any energy that's needed, balance energy so that they all feel even and balanced. So just balancing the energy may also, help. So I would say maybe just kind of do that around the time that one's going to attempt to astral project. That might help. Another thing that's worked for me is just shifting over into the lines of force technique. It's pretty simple technique. Just visualize two points here, and there's these lines that shoot out like lasers out in front of me, several feet, and they come to a point. They meet at a point further out in front of me, like up in the air, because I'm like on the bed, so it would be out toward the ceiling. And then these two lines, it's because they start here, these two points start pulling outward this way. So this triangle, narrow triangle, is now extending outward. That has worked for me for exiting the body. There's something about this area here and these areas here, these points here, where the eyes themselves don't move inward or outward. At least it's what I find, is that it's just this feeling of focus that it creates some sort of energy here and some sort of energy here. And it has just led to just suddenly being out of body, just being out of body. And sometimes like I'm in a totally different location and I'm lucid. And so that has worked for me. And the other thing is, that I see often is swallowing and itching. So with swallowing and itching and not wanting to interrupt the stillness of meditation, the stillness involved with attempting astral projection and swallowing, breaking that, or having an itch and wanting to itch the itch and that interfering. So with meditation, what I tend to do is I give myself a couple minutes in the beginning to position myself, to scratch and get myself comfortable. And then other times I find like after I take a shower is a great time for me to meditate because I've just like scrubbed my body. I'm comfortable, you know, relaxed. And I tend, you know, to find that that is helpful. Another thing is attempting to astral project as soon as I wake up, like before I start moving or I've just moved a tiny bit, and just immediately going into the lines of force technique. I found that that is really helpful because I don't even have time to even think about or even be in a physical state where I need to swallow, where I'm scratching an itch. I'm so relaxed from having just slept. My body's super relaxed because I'm just really waking up. Immediately go into the lines of force visualization, boom, and I end up somewhere else. So that's been helpful. I find that it happens quickly right after waking up if I go into lines of force. Okay, and then the last thing I want to mention is the change of reality that a person might be hesitant, you know, about. Unknown change, right? Because if a person experiences something like astral projection and they realize that consciousness exists outside of the body, that consciousness is like, you know, using this vehicle, is in this in these vehicles, right, our bodies to experience this reality, but that it can also go out and go elsewhere and experience other realms and even other time periods, and that, you know, and you can verify that in fact that is what you're experiencing, you can test it, that it can change profoundly a person's sense of reality, a person's paradigm can shatter. And that is a huge thing. It's a huge change in perspective, in experience. And I would say it's very good. It's very positive, but that might not be the case for everyone because everyone's in a different place. Everyone's going through different things. Everyone handles things differently, you know, and realizing that existence, that consciousness, you know, is very different from what modern society, like you get a different insight. There's different insight to energy and how it is that people exist and experience reality. And that's a really big life change. I would say for me, it's been really positive. Just amazing. But it's just something that someone should contemplate and really think about, like the seriousness of it. And if they're ready for something like that, that there are things that can be done, a person can experience, that are like other steps before astral projection or other things they can do, that are like smaller steps to see, you know, how they feel, if they're comfortable, with that shift. With that shift. So, like energy, there are different energy exercises. There's meditation, things that can be done in meditation, like meditating with others and so on, where a person gets an experience of consciousness and how consciousness, we have our own consciousness, right? We're conscious as a person, and then we're conscious as a collective humanity. And I remember in one of my psychology classes a long time ago in college, I remember it was addressed and a professor said that you know, there's consciousness and there's a collective unconscious. And that we know that it's there, because this is like very like stringent, like scientific, you know, like, you know, area of study that, you know, where the professor was coming from. The professor said that the collective unconscious is there, that's known to be there, but we don't know like how or why. Like we just know that it's there, and it's a collective unconscious. So there's our consciousness as individuals, and then there's our consciousness as a whole. So there are ways to experience things like that, like the collective unconscious, meditating with others, or things that one can do, I would say, that are maybe less intimidating, so they can maybe get comfortable or kind of just get a sense of what that's like, to see if that's a direction they want to go. But yeah, astral projection, I mean, it's usually someone that's attempting it, like they know that's what they're after, and they've had either experiences or understandings to the point where that's where they're at, and that's what they're attempting. Sometimes some smaller steps ahead of time might be okay, or maybe experiencing them a little bit more might be okay right before, you know, being open and fully being aware of leaving the body. And there's also being aware as one enters the body. After being out, when you go back in and you feel the body and you're like, oh yes, here, you know, that you're connected back to the body, that's also an interesting experience. I've had these challenges myself, you know, with being like halfway stuck and, you know, and then with sleep paralysis, like, I mean, it depends on how a person sees it. You know, one person can say that it's really, really scary. And it's really, really scary to them. And then another person can say, hey, like, why would that be scary? You know, like it doesn't have to be scary. You know what I mean? And so it's a decision. And it also has to do with conditioning, where perhaps they're learning it socially from other people. They've heard stories, like scary stories or whatever. And so these ideas are going into their head and making them feel afraid. Like their exposure of it is like has negativity around it due to like social, you know, these contagious ideas of fear that go around. So I would say, comfort level with sleep paralysis would probably be good. If a person is just comfortable, just fine with it, doesn't make a big deal out of it, or just decides to rethink their position on it, that might help ease chakra balancing, sending love to the solar plexus region. I think just kind of skips over any thoughts a person has to have, like any thoughts of having to think one's way through or calm oneself in that state of being half, you know, in and out of their body. Just send love to the solar plexus region, and that will handle it. At least that's what happened with me. And I didn't have to, that's all I had to do. I didn't have to think about anything else. I didn't even have to make myself leave the body. I just had to send that energy to the solar plexus region. And then I just stayed aware. And then I just automatically lifted up and out. And I was aware of that lifting up and out. So, okay. I hope this is helpful. And, yeah.